Good morning everyone, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm making a very quick video in which we will be talking about organic chemistry again. As you people are already aware that I have started with organic chemistry videos, today we're going to make a quick short topic video which will talk about two most famous scientists belongs to organic chemistry, which are said to be Berzelius and Friedrich Wöhler. Now, why are these two scientists important? We are going to cover that in this video. Here, there was initially when chemistry was not that developed, at that time, different scientists, or even today, different scientists have got different, concept and views about certain topics. So there was this scientist called Berzelius. In the year around 1815, he was a Swedish scientist or Sweden chemist. I have just drawn the cartoon images for those who want to have a clear understanding about it. I did not go for the actual picture, so they're not the scientists, just I'm trying to show two human beings. So there was this Berzelius in 1815, which was a Swedish scientist. He said that he put forth something called as vital force theory. Now, what is this vital force theory? Vital means something which is essential. Essential force theory. This theory says that organic compounds were obtained from nature and there was no method of preparing them in laboratories. So, Berzelius said ki in the laboratories, you cannot make organic compounds. If you want to have organic compound, you can either derive it from plants or animals or, dog, cat, rat, whatever. If you want any organic compound, protein, carbohydrate or anything like that, you have to take it from a natural source. And the natural source can be anything, plants or animals, anything like that. But the only condition is you cannot make it into a laboratory. Organic compounds cannot be synthesized into a laboratory. It is because for synthesis of organic compound, you need an essential force which is not present in the laboratories. This was the concept that Berzelius put forth around 1815. Now there was another scientist who came out to be the hero, said to be Friedrich Wöhler. Around 1828, he was a German chemist and he had something which was actually not in favor or not related or something opposite to what Berzelius said. Friedrich Wöhler put forth, he was continuously trying that whatever is said, is that true or can we make organic compound into a laboratory? He put forth something called as Wöhler synthesis. Now, what did Wöhler do? Wöhler took an inorganic compound, which is said to be ammonium cyanate, and he simply heated it. After heating, he saw that ammonium cyanate, which was an inorganic compound, got converted into something amazing, which is called as urea. And urea is an organic compound. Urea is found in the urine of humans or other mammals as well. So now this as organic compound was synthesized into the laboratory, the vital force theory has to be thrown back into the store. So Wöhler synthesis proved that, and nowadays also we know that for synthesis of organic compound, you don't need an essential force. Instead, it can be synthesized into the laboratories as well. Now, there is one statement which Wöhler gave in 1835, and Wöhler said that organic chemistry nowadays almost drives me crazy, drives me mad. To me, it appears like a primeval tropical forest full of the most remarkable things, a dreadful endless jungle into which one does not dare enter, for there seems to be no way out. Okay, so this was all about today's video. See you next time, and if you like my content, like, subscribe and share. Bye bye, see you in the next video. God bless.